Excuse me. Miriam.
Fianza,
se lo viste con su hijo ahí. Y Miriam. En Guzmán. ¿Te voy a dar Whiteman. Englishman. What are you here, boy? I said that's the way we are making on the ranking in a boy. Eh? Right as a boy? A boy? Right as a boy? Very sight of one as I'm English? Eh?
Thank you.
The internet and Facebook is limited.
Thank you. Yeah.
start falling on it again.
Everybody listen to me. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I want to say one thing. You are perfect silent, right? I want to say one thing. I want to know, right now I want to call on Mr. Santoki to say a few words on behalf of my TNM colleague and good friend as a family, Mr. Santoki.
Good afternoon, friends and family. It is not a nice moment, but it's one that we have to reflect on. Peter, as a young boy growing up, I had the cause to have a lot of meetings with him. And he was always one to advise people, do things for your community. Get involved in community work. He was always one to try to, if there is a disturbance, make peace, bring calm. It's a person that, let me say, the PNM family in Faizabad will miss dearly. He was one who knew all the history from the beginning of PNM. There are a lot of people living in the Lai Road who should be very thankful to Peter. I'll call a few streets or trace, Pokaram Street, Ramcharan Trace, Archibald Trace, Ramsuki Trace. It is through Peter's direct drive and will to get accommodation for the people that they have these roads for them to be able to traverse to their homes. Peter is a person we would not forget so fast. We'll always be remembered. And I ask each and everyone to please bid Peter a fond farewell from us. Thank you.
Forget Baba Green and Adila Road. Peter Polidor responsible for that.
Yes, Sam Duffy. Well, sir. What is it time now? What I want to say is this.
150.
Huh? 150. What I want to say, I want people to listen. Now, after I watch around here today, it had to be something that my father do to get all this kind of good farewell. My father lived here for the past 50 years. I mean, I was around at my niece, my nieces, my nephew, my sister-in-law. I realized that we have a big family. We have a big family. And I want to say, of extension, the Polidor family come from the Cornwall race. Right? The Cornwall, the Sylvester, the Lucases, the Williams, the Turpin, all of them is the same family. What I like about my father, well, you know, his roots spread from Grenada. And what I like about him, he never refused his Grenadian people knowing. Whether it's family or not family, he loves you. Till that time, people used to say, look, family going there, you know. Right? And that is in a sense alone shows something. And you know, when I look around like my niece, I know in the near future we'll have one of the biggest families because it's more girls and advising them now, try and keep the surname. Even though you're married, try and keep his surname. So we got know where the family went. What I want to say, thanks to the Delay Road people. You know, I have to say that too, because here he born and here he does flams out. I have to say flams out. Now, I born and grew up here. And I tell you something. You see, politics does divide people. Right? But it does divide people, like in Delay Road here, only when it come around. But everybody live here in a unity. Indian and Negro. I have 2-3 sister-in-laws in India, and I have a Negro. Well, I don't have a wife, but I know. I survive it. The Cornwall, the OGs, and them people in Point, the pill boats on them to feed my family. They're not here today due to some reason or the other. And I know that they have it on the links and they'll hear their name calling. My great, my son, who lives at Alaska, Joshua, daddy saying hello to you. I love you. I love my father. But the point I'm making is, and I want people to take that too. See your family, care about your family. You see your children, care about your children. Put food on the table for them, educate them. So if they take it, there are nobody to blame at the end of the day. What I should say, thanks. And I watch my sister here, Margaret, come. And I watch my sister here, nursing my father. You know, I say, girl, I cannot come down here. I wouldn't come down here. Because when I come and I see my father, I know the kind of person he is, I used to cry. My sister says, still come. You know, and Monday last, I get up. I get a news, come down home. I know that was the last. So everybody who come here and sup with the Polido family, I want to say thank you. Thank you to the Most High. So, we're going in the church now. We're going on our final prayer and then we will proceed to Apex Cemetery. Thank you everybody who came here. Love you all. Extension to all the different branches of the family. The Cornwall, the Lucas, and them. Point, Tobago. Sylvester the Cornwall, thanks Grenada. To you all. Miaro, Grenada, etc. This is my word. Thank you.
And I born and I thank you. You never make nobody show in our child and all are we here, we born. And you will always carry on.
What is your Tisha? They're waiting on you, yeah.
Foundation. I'm telling mommy sister, she don't know certain things because you know why? Thank God. This is the first person in my family to die by. Talk now. Thank God. I love him.
Going to look at the Marco, want to ask you guys? Martel, come now. We close enough, you want to go. Come on, what's all the grandma? Because all you don't know. All you don't know if all you're going to see me.
Thank you. why they report you out.
Thank you.
Thank you. John Polido was the child of Catherine Polido and Haynes Cummings, born on October 9, 1930 in River Sally, Grenada. He was the first of 15 children shared between his parents. The first. He was a born leader and destined for greatness. At a tender age of 5, he migrated to Trinidad and Tobago, where he made Faisabad his hometown. He attended the Forest Reserve Anglican School, where he received his primary level education. He always told us stories about walking barefooted on dirt roads, what we all now know as the field roads, and through the bush from school to home and back. He used the term through the papaya to describe the journey. Later, Peter Polido went on to start his career in the oil industry, where he worked as a foreman for many years. But that wasn't all he did. He was the king of productivity. Our grandfather was the scout leader of the first Sea Scout group in Safaria. He was a member of the St. John's Ambulance Brigade, played football and cricket. He was also the president of Delay Road Village Council, and was popular for hosting his yearly outings to beaches along the East Coast for the Independence Day holiday. Outings that started before most of his grandchildren were born, if not all of us. He was also a bartender for the Petitrin Sports and Staff Club at Faisabad. All events they had, they can call on Polido, as they knew he was a hardworking and very punctual man. My grandfather was very dedicated and committed to any task he was assigned to. Being born in 1930 meant that he experienced a lot of great and terrible times in history. He always boasted to us about meeting the Honorable Dr. Eric Williams. Little did we know, our grandfather formed the first PNM party group in Faizabad and successfully invited Dr. Eric Williams to visit the constituency. He was what we called a PNM stalwart. That man did not make good when it came to his party. Every meeting, he was there. Election, oh, he was there. Every event, he was present and would encourage us all to attend. These were just the beginning of his achievements. Peter Polino was also a very proud Catholic. He was serious about his faith. Every day, he would tell us about his experiences in church. I'm sure all of us heard the story about the day he was baptized. He said, the priest told his mother that he was such a pretty baby that he had to be his godfather as well. I said, Papa, so he thought you were a girl, pretty? He replied, well, I was so nice, I was prettier than the girls and all. He would listen to Mass on the radio and recite his novena and Our Father. His children also recall times that they would hear him praying in his room. He boasted about being named after Saint Peter and said that he was the Saint Peter of today and he will be at the gates of heaven when his time came. Our grandfather believed in family and togetherness. He would go out of his way to ensure that everyone he loved was taken care of and knew each other. Every Christmas and other holidays, we would visit our relatives all over the country. Although we groaned and complained a lot initially, it was fun to meet relatives who never met before and hear the stories Papa and Dave shared. It became a tradition for our parents, Papa and us, to get into a car at no later than 8 a.m. and drive from Faizabad to Superior Road, to Points, and even all the way to Cedars by 6 a.m. By 6 a.m., you can find him sitting in his spot in the gallery, fully dressed, and waiting for us to get ready. Such a punctual man. Polydor could never be late for an event, and if he was, you would never hear the end of it. Peter Polydor was a treasure trove of wisdom. People referred to him as an historian, as he would educate us all on the topics before we even learned them in school. If someone would say something inaccurate on a radio station or television program, he would make it his duty to call in and correct them. And don't even think for a second you can argue, because he was the greatest debater of all time. On Independence Day 2016, he was invited by the then president, Anthony Thomas Aquinas Camuna, to attend the annual President's Award ceremony. I have the honor of accompanying him to this special occasion, and what an honor it was. Shaking the hand of the President and other renowned persons in our country, that experience will forever be a proud moment for me, and I'm grateful to my grandfather for the doors that he opened. Papa, I would miss everything about you. Our arguments, the way you would refer to me as darling or mama, I would miss getting up at 3 a.m. to study and hearing you trying to convince me that it's 6 a.m. The way you would randomly sit next to me and speak your mind. I would miss your desire to keep up with my schooling. You'd always ask, how much years again for nursing? But oddly, what I'd miss the most is testing your glucose levels and administering medication every morning. You were such a willing man, never once gave me opposition when it came to your health. You trusted me and I trusted you. Oh, Papa, you were so good to me. You helped take care of me, and in return, I did my best to help take care of you in your last days.
You are someone I would always hold in high regards, and to me, my precious grandfather could do no wrong. Such an amazing man. Please be my guardian angel through this rough journey called life. Papa, I love you, my everything. The word great can be heard throughout this reality because we believe that it is the word that best emulates the person my grandfather was. A great man, husband, father, grandfather, friend, leader, and exemplar, who did great things during his time here with us. When we all hear the name Peter Polydor, we will remember him, not in sadness, but with great pride, because we got to experience the great legacy he was. His presence will be dearly missed, but his life was well lived. We leave you with his scripture to reflect on, and I'm sure we will all find comfort in knowing that Papa lived forever in our hearts and memories.
John 3:25. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. Rest in peace, son, brother, husband, daddy, papa, general, stalwart, great man, uncle, and friend. We love you.
God has loved him. As he was living among sinners, he has been taken up. He has been carried off so that evil may not grasp his understanding or treachery seduce his soul. For the fascination of evil throws good things into the shade, and the whirlwind of desire corrupts a simple heart. Coming to perfection is so short a while, he achieved long life, his soul being pleasing to the Lord. He has taken him quickly from the wickedness around him. Yet people look on, uncomprehending. It does not enter their heads that grace and mercy awaits the chosen of the Lord and protection his holy ones. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I'll read it from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We sing. This short reflection is centered on the gospel reading, with a few words from the first reading. The first reading taken from the book of Isaiah, from the book of wisdom, sorry, has a lot of messages for us, a lot of blessings. Some of the values we hold so dear in life are sometimes contradictory to things that really matter. Just like Jesus and our Blessed Mother Mary, you know that great song of our Mother Mary, the Magnificat. Here it says, the Lord sends the rich empty away, then the hungry he feeds with good things. But we know that in our world today, the rich are the ones who are filled with good things, and the poor are the ones sent empty away. But for God, it is the reverse. The same thing with our Lord Jesus Christ. If you go through the Sermon on the Mount, it is really filled with parables. Not as the world understands happiness. For the world to be happy, you need to be on top. You need to conquer everything. You need to be the first. Might is power. And that's what we believe. But that's what Jesus Christ. He believed that it is about the sincerity of our heart and purity of our soul. It is from there comes joy and happiness. And not what we possess, or what I eat, or the kind of car I have, or the mansion I'm living in. So when the book of wisdom says, the souls of the righteous are in the hands of God. For a worldly man, people understand that those who are enjoying life, those who found favor with God, is all about material acquisitions and what you have and what you possess. No. The book of wisdom is telling me and also telling you that the length of years is not what makes life honorable. No. It's not an ability to live 100 years and to live 80, live above 80 years. Not at all. But even if a person dies at the age of 20, in the eyes of God, he will be an old man who has achieved his aim in life, having fulfilled all the goals God has set for him. How? soul, this is God. And one may ask, how can my soul please God? How can I fulfill the goal God has sent me into this world? That will lead us also to ask the necessary question, why am I here on earth? What is the essence of my being here? It is only those who understand it that will walk towards fulfillment of that for which God has sent them. If you find yourself and you see life as it is about eating, drinking, acquiring material things and rest of them, if you don't have them, you don't need to feel. But if you see life as a gift from God, and this gift God has given me is not just for myself, it's also for people around me, to impact positively on them, you can achieve it even when you are faced. At the age of 15, you can achieve that. We have had people who live below 20 years, and they are intact, still in health, in the neighborhood and community, the present. And there are people who live 100 years and they go. When they die, they are actually forgotten. Because they left no legacy, no good word that people will look up to. And how do we achieve our soul being in the hands of God? That is life, characterized by righteousness. How do we achieve it? Look at Psalm 24 and Psalm 15. Lord, who shall ascend to your mountain? Who will be in your holy place? And this psalm answered that question. The man with clean hands and pure hearts. The man with clean hands and pure hearts. So if you want your soul to be in the hand of God when you depart this earth, then there is a need for us to work towards making our soul to be pure and our hands clean. It's not about washing the sanitizer, no, or hot water and soap, not at all. But about love, forgiveness, being human, because the problem we have in our world today is that a lot of people are so religious without being human. They pray for money to life, but they can't be delivered. The world all around them. Immediately after prayer, you see them singing praises of God. They go to pilgrimage from one nation to another, seeking for God. But God is here with our brothers and sisters. God is walking on our streets. God is with the people who hunger and who are sick. God is among us. Remember the name, Isaiah told us that the son that the virgin will conceive will be, he will be called Emmanuel, God with us. But we see God as someone separated from us, very far away. So when we are doing everything, it's like he's not aware, he's not around, he's not seeing us. So we do whatever we want and whatever we like. And that's how the brother would treat the other brother in business. And sit among brothers and sisters and spouses. And yet we pride ourselves as Christians. We are not going to be pure and our hands be clean. Don't get filled with grudges and resentment. So if you really want your soul to be in the hand of God, then start to use them and let go to forgive. Not to keep malice anymore. To make sure that people around us experience immense love from us. If you are a good man, a good woman, you will be a good Christian. If you are really a good but a good woman who will be a good Christian. But it is an admiration for someone to be a good Christian and a bad man. No, the two don't go together. But that's what we find ourselves today, because people believe that, oh, relationship with God is about prayer.
Because our God
the beginning, the journey towards his conversion. So my dear brothers and sisters, what are we doing on this road? So let us understand that life is not just about us taking decision and doing what we like. There is God who will demand account of how we have lived our life. And he has given us faithful on what to do. The Gospel of St. Matthew, I quoted earlier, chapter 25, is one of them. Then, if you want to be happy in eternal life, you go to the Gospel of St. Matthew also, chapter 5, the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who hunger, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, they shall be shown mercy. And many other blessings. So if you want to then go and read and unpack them, put into practice. Putting them into practice is in our relationship with one another, in our families, and in our communities. And finally, in the gospel, Jesus said, come to me, or you put their home and put away. I understand and also know that loss of the loved one. Always a pain, it's a worry, but God is always there to console us, to bear with us, to lighten the burden for us. So, as whenever we invite God into our challenges and trials and temptations, the road is easier, the burden is lighter. Yes, you may not have all the people you expected to be with you at this time of mourning, but always know that the prayer of the church accompanies you to console you. You are not alone in this grief. And many of us will say we're not Christian, God. That His will is the best thing for us in life. And remember, the book of Ecclesiastes told us this. There's time for everything. And once it's time, God will ask it. And we have set His holy will for us. The only thing we owe to our brother is to remember Him in our prayers and masses. And then cross on our life. The good thing is to let behind cross to continue. Is it time that make people around you happy? That you have been being the gate at the gate of heaven to welcome people who are coming, you will be glad to see you. The door and you are there. So strive and do your best so that when the door opens and He is standing by you, not as Peter, who has the key to heaven, that you are also welcome. This can only happen when we listen to the voice of God and live righteously. Live righteously. Take our relationship with God seriously and also love your brothers and your sisters. How long do we stay in this life? It's not much. I don't think we have enough time to keep marriage, to follow, to continue to be bitter in the heart. Let us use the little opportunities and time we have to be good to people and others. Try to be good so that when you are no more, people will always remember you for your goodness. For your goodness. If you are good, if you are trying your best to know, if you are envious, if you are wicked in me, you also go. I have had experience. This is first closing. I had experience of a young girl coming to me. And she said, Father, I just want to know. I'm drawn to fellow ladies. I'm attracted to fellow ladies. You see, they say, tell yourself the truth, because your conscience has told you that what you are doing is not right. So when we are doing wrong thing, we know. You can justify it with anything. You can try to explain it away with anything. But our conscience is always there to remind us. And that's why sometimes people who involve themselves in violent crime and other crime in society, they take drugs or they drink. Because as human, God has put his own spirit inside us to tell us what is true and what is bad. No matter how you try to kill your conscience, it will always want to remind you of the essence of being good. God, the Lord Almighty, raise Christ the Son from the dead, with confidence in asking to save all these people, living and dead. For our brother Peter, in baptism, was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of his friends. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Thank you. your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a Lord and Savior may find in him the merciful judge who lives in the land forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. you have called from this world to yourself. Brother, he who was united with your Son in a death like this, may also be brought with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have been asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all of their life in mercy. Welcome to the night of the Lord. Come and listen to us all with prayer. Now, blessed is Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph and our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who are pleased with all the ages. We pray to the full heads of the Father, we praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through me, I will be and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
To render words of tribute to the stature of a man that was Peter John Polidor. My words will not do justice to what Mr. Polidor has contributed to the community of Faizabad. My words cannot capture the full extent of his 60 years plus service to party and to his fellow man. Years of industry, sacrifice, and commitment. Years of successes and disappointments. Years of laughter and tears. Years which, in the end, created unbreakable unifying bonds. Since the news of his passing on 9th August, condolences, tributes, and genuine concern for the family and relatives of Mr. Polidor have been endless. These things I have been asked to extend on behalf of the members of the PNM Faizabad constituency family, the former and current coordinators, the General Secretary, and the political leader, Dr. the Honorable Keith Christopher Rowley. Evidently, Mr. Polidor is not leaving us without engraving in us positive marks from which we can learn and grow. My experiences with Peter are many. He was loved and respected, and he deserved it. Because he loved, he was loved. Because he was gentle, he was treated with gentleness. Because he respected everyone regardless of age, he was respected. Because he made people a priority, he was made a priority. Mr. Polidor greeted all with a smile and always had a story to share. No matter how busy one was, sitting and chatting with Mr. Polidor could never be considered wasting time. For Mr. Polidor was Mr. Polidor. He never came to you empty-handed, and he never forgot to ask, how is the family going? And as a stalwart of the PNM and a pillar of the Faizabad constituency, Peter Polidor will continue to be described as a giant of a man, a faithful and loving soldier, a warrior for the party, a political historian, a Faizabad constituency champion, and most endearingly, the oldest and dearest person to me in the Faizabad constituency. Mr. Polidor was not only a PNM stalwart, he was also my friend and a man I wanted to at my side in any political battle. He was extremely loyal to his friends. He was a lobbyist for his family, and he always had betterment for the people of the Faizabad constituency on his mind. We have truly lost a great one. I am certain that the likes of Peter Polidor cannot be duplicated. The reality that when I show up at the office, he won't be sitting on the bench waiting for me to show up. The reality that he will not be there with me to answer the call of the ringing of the next election bell. The reality that I cannot pick up the phone and give him a quick call truly breaks my heart beyond comprehension. To Mr. Peter Polidor, I would like to say thank you. Thank you for being the political mentor that we all needed, for your patience yet determined persona. Thank you for your dedication and service to the people and community of Faizabad. Thank you for your friendship and your loyalty to the PNM family and us as individuals. And as a man with the name of two disciples of Jesus Christ, our Lord, thank you for living up to your names, Peter and John, and for being a true disciple and servant of the people, I guess doubly so. Rest assured that we will continue your good works and continue to carry the PNM flag high. Rest peacefully, soldier. You have done well. You have finished the race strong. From your PNM Faizabad constituency family, we say farewell and thank you.
The spirit of faith in the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like He in glory. For He is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. God will bless and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the soul. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope to your last day. We ask to Christ our Lord. Eternal rest, grant unto the people of God. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful in God, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and mind in the knowledge and love of God. Our Lord Jesus Christ, and Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peter and John, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And favorize us is all no longer. May you find eternal blessings. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Some people can't do it.
We coming?
Put the flowers.
Come on, just
take a look.
Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you have overcome death for us. Through his burial and resurrection from the dead, you have made the grave a holy place. For those who died believing in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again, God of the living and the dead, may those who faithfully believe in you on earth praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Through the mercy of God, may Peter and all the faithful departed rest in peace of Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
In the hope of the resurrection, let us leave our brother Peter to rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. May he rest in peace.
Praise the Lord.
Where are
you? That's the one. That's the one. That's the one. That's the one. That's the one.
you always
When we don't fix it up nice, okay. Then we don't.
Yeah,
you got it?
Yeah, yeah. Let go.
Yeah.
Not only 4 feet, it have a box in the hole. Yes. A lot of people like to come to complain. What's in here? You better come up in your room. What are you going to do?
You're welcome, darling. Are you mother?
Yeah.
Go to the next.
Oh, no. Young boy, you go ahead and do your work. We go handle it.
Next thing down.